What do you do when the entire world turns upside down? Gravity reversed. Once was rising, now ever more falling, never more to rise again. Happiness into sorrow, light into shadow, water into flame, pride into shame, pleasure into pain, beauty into disgust, clarity into insanity, hope into despair, love into hatred, life into death, blessings into damnation. What do you do when something in possession of the most unassailably sacrosanct essence and utmost angelic beauty, something so priceless, so irreplaceable, something so unimaginably special, that it bears the capability to exist only once, and not just one lifetime, but infinite lifetimes, something to be born only once in the midst of all eternity, is miraculously born in your lifetime, during your embodiment of consciousness, discovering your existence, coming into your being, and performing a spiritual union with your soul, invoking omnipresent divinity in your life with omnipresent heaven light, and inducing the most steadfast will to rejoice and the greatest extent of gratitude for a lifelong period of enlightenment, then is intently, maliciously obliterated from the face of the universe by the darkest, most malevolent entities of hell, evermore condemned into an eternal negation of existence, to nevermore resurrect from the nothingness of its infernal distinction, inflicting a perpetual calamity of merciless, incapacitating grief, disbelief, anxiety, mental devastation, and incurable emotional contamination, procreating the everlasting morbid echoes of decadent prayers and relentless lamentation of mindless desperation from the voice of collapsed lungs, shredded vocal cords, and shattered knees, despotently yet ceaselessly bestowed onto the winds of indifference from the most immeasurable depths of the purity of your soul until the arising of death. What do you do when you have the most inexpressibly beautiful, realistic dream of your life, a dream of the most invincible tranquility, the most sparkling and placid of seas, the brightest, most luminous sun, moon, and stars, the bluest, most serene of skies, the whitest and softest of clouds, the most perennial and invulnerable of trees, the greenest, most gentle of grass, the reddest, most thornless of roses, the largest and most yellow of sunflowers, the most lavender and basil of irises, the lightest, most soothing of winds, the most continuous and humble of smiles, and where the deepest, most sincere desires of your heart are all summoned to life simultaneously before your very eyes, illuminating the ubiquitous, ever-radiant bliss of a paradise that can be born only from the incantations of the most unfathomably pure and spellbindingly beautiful angel in existence within and metaphysically beyond the entire cosmic universe, only to watch the dream in the most blinding flash of epileptic abruptness vanish into the far unknown corners of the universe as the dream executioner of cold reality viciously and nauseously tears through the conscious mind. And even if the forbearance of mercy had, in fact, met the will to restrain from the very eradication of your capability to dream, or fall into merely an ordinary state of slumber, the very self-same angelic dream is evermore forbidden by all omnipotent transcendental entities to return in any aspect of your cognizance, discernment, or visual penetration, nevermore to arise from exilic oblivion for the remainder of the sempiternal existence of your soul. When you are slowly ascending an infinite staircase with a direct course to the gates of heaven, gazing upon them in your immediate sight as you continuously ascend in the midst of the smooth pink skies and the constant motion of the whispering light yellow clouds, never removing your sight from the colossal golden gates that stand at such a near destination, but in spite of the countless repetitive steps you take, you are ignorantly ascending with no further approach to the entrance, never drawing the gates nearer or yourself nearer to the gates as you walk up the staircase, being unconsciously trapped within the motionlessness of infinity's motion, with no capability or possibility to ever reach your destination, yet never altering your fixation from the golden lustrous serenity of heaven's gates and the sacred realm of white light that shines behind it, never blinking, never losing determination, never intending to relinquish the dream, the absolute dominance of your being, of walking through the gateway and embracing the ever-envelopment of the light. But somewhere amidst the disturbance deviation-free ascension, you were abruptly deviated from your ascent and as if from nowhere, an unforeseen wind of the most powerful vehemence knocks you off the staircase. And now, you are no longer walking, no longer climbing, but descending, falling, feeling the pressure of the air from under you, flowing not around you, but through you, penetrating you from within, lifting you in your descent as you fall, forever fall, but gravity seeming non-existent, as if you are floating in midair, the vertical distance between you and the gates of heaven not able to increase, the horizontal distance between you and the gates no more or less from when you were walking upon the infinite staircase, unchanged, unaffected, consciousness finally meeting the incapability of distance modification and control from the indifference between ascent and descent, the only power possessed being to induce movement in the eyes, limbs, and torso, and in spite of it all, never are you deprived from your fixations, the once embarked journey, the now deserted infinite staircase, the original destination, the bright glowing golden gates to internal enlightenment that stands so near yet so far from your sight, as the staircase now stands right beside you, incapable of being approached in spite of how far you reach, the efforts you impel, never bringing the staircase nearer to you or yourself nearer to it. Nevermore can you resume the prior engagement of your journey and its conceivable action, the prior pursuit of the light, and evermore are you incapable to initiate actuation of distance towards or from the staircase or the gates of heaven, evermore condemned to endlessly anticipate when and if you will ever plunge into the blackness and fire pits of hell, to free you from your icy prison, but nevermore to be given euthanasia from consciousness, nevermore to be released from your frozen eternity inside the ice of infinity. Witness the supernova of the brightest, most gargantuan star in the endless abyss of the universe, and fall into the ineludible gravitational pull of the supermassive black hole it becomes. Evermore will your disintegrated soul dwell within the gravitational imprisonment. Nevermore will you escape the singularity. Welcome to the most unspeakably bottomless pit of excruciating terror and eternal damnation. Welcome to the realm of ever nevermore.
Special effects? Panda, dance!
I am, I'm moving my lips.
Are you hungry?
Oh boy.
Yo. What?
We look so excited.
Boobies.
Man, no boobies.
How long does it go for?
Whenever?
Yeah.